This is Jeanette Androvier.
Welcome to Everest Physics Academy.
Before we start, we'd like to recommend our Everest Physics books for high school,
where you can find more explanations and solve applications and the problems.
In this video, we are going to calculate the value of the electromotive force induced in a coil, indicate the direction of the current induced in the coil using Faraday's law and Lenz's law, calculate the value of the induced current, calculate the voltage across the coil, draw the circuit of the equivalent generator.
In the first figure, a coil having 100 identical square loops, each of side A equal 10 cm. So the length of this side is equal to 10 cm, and the length of this side is also equal 10 cm. The coil is connected with a resistor of resistance R equal 45 ohm. The internal resistance of the coil is R equal 5 ohm, and the coil is placed in a uniform magnetic field whose magnitude B varies with time according to the shown graph. As you see on the second figure, B decreases from 1 to 0.2 Tesla during the first 8 seconds, and then it remains constant during 8 and 12 seconds. The first figure shows the coil, which is represented between M and N by the green color, and this coil is connected to the resistor of resistance R. The figure shows also the direction of the magnetic field, which is directed outward or directed towards the observer. Question number 1. Consider the time interval 0.8 seconds. 1A, determine the value of the electromotive force E induced in the coil. As you know, to determine E, we have to determine the expression of the magnetic flux crossing through the coil. The flux is given by an SB scalar N, or NBS cosine, the angle between N and B, where N is a unit vector normal to the plane of the loop, and this unit vector is determined or depends on the positive sense. The positive sense is oriented in the clockwise, so curl the fingers of your right hand in the positive sense or in the clockwise sense, the thumb points inward, so N is directed inward. As you see, the angle between B and N is equal to pi radians, or 180 degrees. So phi becomes NB A squared, which is equal to S, since each loop has a square shape. As you know, the area of a square is equal to the side times the side. So S is equal to A squared, and the angle between N and B is equal to pi radians. Now substitute each physical quantity by its value. Cosine pi is equal to minus 1, N is equal to 100 turns, and A is equal to 10 centimeter, which is equivalent to 0.1 meter. Therefore, phi is equal to minus B. Now, using Faraday's law, E is equal minus the time derivative of the flux. Therefore, E equal minus into minus dB by dt. So E equal dB by dt. Pay attention. E equal dB by dt, it is not a new formula. It's just a relation valid only on this problem, and we will use this relation in the whole problem whenever we want to calculate E. So E equal dB by dt, and dB by dt is the slope of the curve between 0 and 8 seconds. As you know, this slope is given by V2 minus V1 over T2 minus T1. We take 2 points from the graph. First point having an abscess 8 seconds and an ordinate 0.2 Tesla, and the second point having an abscess 0 and an ordinate 1 Tesla. Therefore, dB by dt is equal to 0.2 minus 1 over 8 minus 0, which is equal to minus 0.1 Tesla per second. Therefore, the induced electromotive force during the first 8 seconds in the coil is equal to minus 0.1 volt.
Part 1b. Deduce the direction of the induced current carried by the coil. The coil acts as a generator, so E and I have the same sign, which means that EI is positive. In the previous slide, We calculated the value of E. It is minus 0.1 volts, which means that E is negative, then I is also negative. Look at the figure. The chosen positive sense is clockwise, then the current is counterclockwise. It is opposite to the chosen positive sense. Part 1C, determine again the direction of the induced current by using Lenz's law. Now, in the time interval 0.8 seconds, the magnitude of the magnetic field is decreasing with time. So, according to Lenz's law, the direction of the induced magnetic field produced by the induced current is outwards to oppose the decrease in B. Now, let's apply the right-hand rule to determine the direction of the induced current. Curl the fingers of your right hand. Your thumb must point outwards in the direction of the induced magnetic field. If your thumb points outwards, then your fingers are curled in this direction, which is the direction of the induced current. So the induced current is counterclockwise.
Part 1D. Determine the value of the current I. Since the action verb is determine, so you have to prove the relation among I, E, and the total resistance of the circuit. Now, the positive sense in the coil is oriented from M to N. So, UMN is equal to IR minus E. Also, the positive sense is directed from N to M through the resistor. So we can write UNM through the resistor is equal to IR. As you know, UNM is equal to minus UMN. Therefore, UMN is equal to minus IR. But UMN is equal to UMN. So we can write IR minus E is equal to minus RI. Rearrange I small r plus I capital R equal E. This is going to be I equal E over R plus R. Now substitute the value of each physical quantity. E is equal to minus 0.1, proved or calculated in the previous slide. R, or the capital R, is equal to 45 ohm, and the small r, or the internal resistance of the coil, is equal to 5 ohm. Therefore, the induced current in the circuit is equal to minus 2 times 10 to the power minus 3 ampere, which is equivalent to minus 2 milliampere.
Let's move to part 1e. Calculate the voltage UMN. The values of I and E1 are calculated in the previous parts. Now, to calculate the voltage UMN, we can calculate it across the coil or across the resistor. Let's start by calculating it across the resistor. The positive sense flows in the resistor from N to M. So, UNM is equal to plus IR. But we want UMN, so UMN is equal to minus IR. The current is minus 2 times 10 to the power minus 3 amperes, and the resistance is 45 ohms. This is going to be 0.09 volts or 90 millivolts. Now, across the coil, the positive sense is from M to N. So UMN is equal to IR minus E. So, replace each physical quantity by its value, and the answer is, again, it is 0.09 volts or 90 millivolts. Now, let's move to part 1F. Draw the circuit of the equivalent generator of this coil. When drawing the equivalent generator, we draw a series combination of the internal resistance R and an ideal battery of electromotive force E1. So this is the equivalent generator. When drawing the equivalent generator, pay attention to 4 points. First, you must locate the terminals of the coil on the figure. Second, indicate correctly the direction of the current. So, in the first figure, the current flows in the coil from N to M. So, we have it here also from N to M. Third, the internal resistance and the battery are connected in series. So, Order is not important. You can draw the internal resistance to the right or to the left, no problem. Finally, the current must flow out from the positive pole of the ideal battery. So if you draw the ideal battery like this, the figure is not correct.
Focus, please. This is important.
Number 2. Determine the value of the induced current in the time interval 8 seconds, 12 seconds. This relation is proved in part 1. The induced electromotive force in the coil is equal to the time derivative of the magnetic field. But the graph shows that between 8 and 12 seconds, B is constant with time. Therefore, the derivative of the magnetic field is equal to 0. Then E is also equal to 0. When there is no induced electromotive force in the circuit, there is no current in the circuit.
Let's move to part 3. In the time interval 12 seconds, 16 seconds, the expression of the value of the magnetic field is B equals 0.4 T minus 4.6 SI. SI means the times expressed in seconds and B in Tesla. Let's move to part 3A. Determine the value of the electromotive force E3 induced in the coil and deduce the value of the induced current I carried by the coil. The obtained expression of E in this problem is dB by dt. So we need to differentiate this expression with respect to time. The derivative of 0.4 t with respect to time is 0.4, and the derivative of minus 4.6 is 0. So E3 is equal to 0.4 volts. Now let's calculate the current. The expression of the current is E3 over R plus R. So E3 is equal to 0.4 volts, and the internal resistance and the resistance R add up to 50 ohms. So the answer is 8 times 10 to the power minus 3 amperes. Part 3b. Calculate the voltage UMN. We can calculate UMN across the resistor or across the coil. So we choose to calculate it across the coil. UMN is equal to IR minus E3. Remember, we follow the positive sense. Now, the current is 8 times 10 to the power minus 3 amperes. The internal resistance is 5 ohms and E3 is 0.4 volts. And the answer is minus 0.36 volts or minus 360 millivolts.
Part 3C. The positive sense is reversed. As you see, it becomes counterclockwise. Determine the voltage UMN again, and then deduce whether the value of UMN depends on the choice of the positive sense. The signs of E and I depends on the positive sense, and the expression of the voltage UMN depends also on the positive sense. So according to the new positive sense, the values of I and E becomes minus 8 times 10 to the power minus 3 ampere and minus 0.4 volt respectively. Now, since the positive sense is oriented from N to M through the coil, so we can write U and M is equal to IR minus E. So replace each physical quantity by each value. I is equal to minus 8 times 10 to the power minus 3. The internal resistance of the coil is equal to 5 ohm. And E3 is equal to minus 0.4 volt. Therefore, U and M is equal to 0.36 volt. But the question to determine UMN. UMN is equal to minus U and M. So UMN is equal to minus 0.36 volt, which is equal to minus 360 millivolt. So we can conclude that the value of UMN does not depend on the chosen positive sense, since the value of UMN calculated in the previous slide is equal to minus 360 millivolt relative to a clockwise positive sense.
To part 4. Draw over the time interval 0-16 seconds the graph that represents UMN as a function of time. We have three time intervals. In the first time interval, 0.08 seconds, UMN is equal to 90 millivolts. In the second time interval, 8 seconds, 12 seconds, UMN is equal to 0. In the third time interval, 12 seconds, 16 seconds, UMN is equal to minus 360 millivolts. We draw this graph. The horizontal axis is the time axis, and the vertical axis represents the voltage. One division along the time axis represents 2 seconds, whereas one division on the vertical axis represents 90 millivolts. The graph shows that UMN is constant during each time interval.
Thank you for watching. If you like this video,
subscribe to the channel, hit the like button, and share.